Welcome to Analytics with Nax. In this video, we are going to see how to read multiple Excel or any CSV files in Power BI using a Power Query. Or if you are looking for how to look through the folders to read multiple files, this is the video for you. If you are new to this channel and you haven't subscribed yet, hit the button right now to learn the concepts in Power BI. We are exploring Power BI using a business scenario, Naga Garments, and he's having three branches. And today we are going to learn this looping concept using one of these challenges. He's getting the sales data from each location on daily basis in Excel file, and he has to extract and report it in Power BI. So he needs some kind of automation. So currently, say for example, he has three locations, right? He don't have a POS. Each location, they are maintaining the sales in Excel. At the end of the day, people from Chennai, Bangalore, Hyderabad, whoever is in charge in these branches, they are sending the Excel to the business owner. And as a business owner, he has to consolidate the things in a single file earlier, and he is trying to find an easy way for it. So what can be done in Power BI? So basically, he can drop all the files in a single folder, and there is a folder data source in Power BI. Using that, he can loop through all the files listed in that folder as well as in the subfolder. Then he can able to read it, consider it as a single file, and create as a single table in Power BI. For this to happen, one of the prerequisite is like for all the files he is receiving from different places or different sources should have a same format, meaning same column headers, and the order of the column should be the same. With this note, let us try to explore this scenario in a demo. So currently in Power BI, so we are said like Excel. So for that, you should not go to Excel here. This is basically a folder source. If you have a multiple files, it can be a Excel or CSV or any other files, okay? And you want to loop through it, you need to go to new source. The source type is nothing but a folder. So you see option at the all itself. When you click on file also, it will appear. So it is folder. Click on connect. And navigate through the path. Let me copy this path. I'm having it here. So let us press OK. When I click on that folder, you immediately see the list of files available in that folder. Okay, so it doesn't matter what files it is. So I gave this path, this video 18. In this, you have these CSV files I need to read. But if you see here, along with the CSV, that is, I mean, XLS file, it also listed my PowerPoint file, that is whatever I opened here. Okay, as well as here, you see the text file. I don't find any text file here, but you see here inside this folder, I have this text file. So when you keep at the top folder, it will go inside your subfolders as well and try to get all the files inside this main folder. Okay, keep this note. And now what we need to do, whether we can ignore anything over here. If you have only the listed files here, then you can use combine option, but I need to ignore unwanted files. That's why I want to go to transform data. So now we have all the files listed. Now either I can do like I can go for filtering unwanted files. I can use the extension .xls, but I would say that is not preferable way to filter, because in this folder, if you have another XLS file added with that contains a different format, okay, instead of sales, you try to calculate some calculations or some other format. If you have dropped in this folder, as you see all files, it will pick it up. That will confuse you or mess up with your existing flow. So better to filter based on the name. The naming convention follows like this, right? So go for text filters contains sales underscore. So it is prerequisite, right? You need to request the source system, whoever providing this file, with specific format of naming convention as well as the data inside your Excel. So I'm saying if the data contains or begins with sales underscore, then give those files alone. Now I filtered it. Okay. The next step I need to do is, you see what are the things it has fetched. It has fetched the metadata of your file. So data access, when it is modified, when it is created and modified, and what is the folder path. This is my folder path. Okay, so I don't want other columns except this name column. So let us try to remove other columns. Remove columns, I selected it. Now I have this data here. Either I can go here and say what I want from this column. And before that step, I want to extract the location. Since I am aware of about this data, so this does not contain any location information inside your column, I mean inside your data. So I want to extract these locations so that I can use it as a filter in my analysis. So I want this data. So let me do quick transformation. So what I want a Bangalore, right? So I need to duplicate this column. Let us duplicate it, then get this location name. For that, I need to remove this first five columns. I can go for split. Split column, split by delimiter, leftmost, each occurrence of a delimiter underscore. Let us do that so that I will get remove this one. Even I can get the date from this column. So Bangalore is one, and your date is there. The date should not have dot XLS. So replace. So replace values. Find dot XLS. So it is not, in my case, it is having the data like this. Based on your data over here, you need to do appropriate transformations. Now I can change it to data type to date for this. So now you can see this is 1st of Jan, 2nd of Jan, like that. Okay, now this is prerequisite. I mean, just for your, I mean, it's not a prerequisite. What I'm trying to say is, if you extract the some metadata or a categorical value from your file name, you can use it as a filter. So this acts as my location. Then this is my date. Now you can expand this files. So click on this content. So click on the data. So this is what I have. I mean, I think I have location inside the data as well. That's fine. Just for your understanding, I've explained it. So click on this data and you see whether this is fine. Then click on OK. So this will expand my all my data. You see, like it come from other fields as well. So here a quick thing I want to highlight. So we were in this step. So after clicking on it, all these steps are created by Power BI automatically when you click on this. So let us try to navigate one by one. So when you go here, it is filtering the hidden files. Then it is invoking some custom function. When you see from difference between this step and this step, it has internally created one table. Okay. So if you see this table, it is trying to fetch data for each file. This is a file name. It is passed and getting that data in a single table. If you click on this, this is the data for this particular file. This is the data for this particular file. Okay. So here I can go and expand myself. Okay. So I will remove these steps. Either if you are not having a custom columns, as I mentioned here, I need to have these columns. Okay. If you click on content directly, it will remove all other columns. It will try to expand it. What I'm trying to do is I want these two columns that I derived from the file. So that's why I'm going step by step. Now I go and expand the required columns here. So I need, ignore this one. I want receipt number. I don't want location. I can use location from there. I choose select columns, whichever. Okay. Let me select item amount, item quantity. This is enough. Now, along with the extracted column, that is name, content, location, you also get the data for your file. So this is the January 1st file. This is the data for it. You can see the January 2nd file. The data differs. Okay. I hope you guys understand this. Let me delete. Then you can remove whatever columns you don't want. And based on this column also you can analyze. And this is the data for that particular date. So you can derive such a things. It's a kind of quick automation. Like instead of this operation, if you do not have a folder, what happens is like you need to manually append all the data in a single file daily. So now once you close and apply daily, when you refresh, whenever the file is added here, if you consider after these six files, four files are added here, refreshing will automatically perform this all these operations automatically. So it's a very good kind of a simple automation. Now at the end you will get a single table. So it is video 18. I need to rename it. So I can rename it as sales daily, something like that. So I can do that. See, now it is reading Hyderabad each file. It's okay. Let us quickly try to rename it here. I can rename it here. Sales daily. So now you see here you have only one table. I did nothing. I used a folder option. Then I choose some formatting. I did some transformation. Then you got all your data in a single table. I hope you guys like this video. Share and subscribe to the channel. Comment below for your queries. Do remember that data is your asset.